Your son thinks being expelled from school means he's on vacation.
My son has not yet been expelled because we still have a meeting for the school board. You know, you can't stay mad at camp forever, honey.
I'm not mad, I'm disappointed. I know there's a good kid in there, but I'll tell you, he's getting harder and harder to find.
I liked you two better when you couldn't be together and you're miserable and pitiful. I need a cigarette.
He's quite a runner. Good form. He's got great stride.
Well, he's only got a couple more laps left if you want to talk to him. I mean, you are a recruiter, right?
No, I just admire good talent. He gave you his medallion.
Yeah. Yeah, his dad gave it to him when he... You're his dad. Oh, my God. You're his dad?
Please don't mention that you've talked to me.
But, I mean, he would want to talk to you.
No, he wouldn't. Please don't tell him.
Cameron. Now, look. I got a couple of boxes up in the attic that I really need help with. Can I count on you this afternoon?
Yeah, sure, Grandma. Pete's homework, right?
Don't get used to it, Cameron. We are going to get you back into school.
And until then, I suggest you spend less time perfecting your jump shot and more time doing things around the house. And I want the keys to your car.
You're taking away my car?
Yes, son, I am.
It's totally not fair.
Put your keys on the counter, Cam. You can start by cleaning out the garage this afternoon. End of discussion.
This isn't my fault, Dad. It was an accident.
Hey, it ended up with a pickup truck driving into a school building. It was stupid and reckless, Cam. You're just lucky nobody got hurt. You know, eventually you're gonna have to take responsibility for yourself and grow up.
But I didn't.
You didn't what?
Marvin. Steve. Yeah, good. Nah, we broke up, man. Story of my life. Listen, I need a loan. $100,000 till Friday.
I mean, hey, you know me. If I didn't need it, I wouldn't ask, right?
Yeah, no, I hear you, man. It's tough all around. No, that's cool. You take it easy. You look good, big brother. How do I look?
You look 4 years older.
Yeah? You gonna let me in?
I don't know. Give me a minute. I'm still in shock. Come in.
Mary!
Oh, my God, Steve! Steve!
There's a chance I might get this job out of the country with Merrill Lynch. So before I move something like 5,000 miles away, I thought I'd drop by and visit my niece and nephews.
Good thing we were home.
I know, I should have called.
That would mean planning ahead, Steve.
What, and ruin my reputation as being the master of spontaneity? Remember the best weekend of your life?
It's a monster truck sports arena.
You guys were supposed to see Beauty and the Beast.
Guys, spewed all over that lady's shoes. What was that?
Tamara. Yeah.
You still seeing her?
No, she wanted to get married. Can you believe that?
What a horrible person.
She ruined a perfectly happy 7-year relationship.
Oh, well, nothing ruins a relationship like commitment.
I'm done cleaning the garage. I'll be in my room.
Honey, you need to eat something. Come on, I'll fix you a plate.
I'm actually not that hungry.
Your grandmother went to the trouble of making a special dinner, and your uncle's here. Have a seat.
I was just thinking that this was going to be the baby's room.
What? You were pregnant?
Yeah, I had a miscarriage.
Wow, Mary, I'm sorry. I didn't know.
You know, Steve, we tried to reach you, but you moved again.
Yeah, I've been going through some rough times. No, I haven't kept in touch like I should have.
Mm-hmm. You know, I stopped counting the times that we got returned birthday cards and Christmas cards and the times we tried to call you, but your number was disconnected.
You know, Mary, I'm not very good at this you've been a bad brother lecture thing.
Well, Mitch worries about you, Steve.
Yeah, he doesn't need to. Okay, the whole reason why I came back here is to set things right.
Yeah?
So there I am, butt naked in the Andersons' backyard, killer Doberman foaming at the mouth. Your dad's already over the fence. Lights are coming on in the house.
Wait, what happened to your clothes?
Well, Mitch took them.
Dad!
Hey, you wanted to be in the club. You knew what the initiation was. You knew the rules.
How did you get out of there?
He didn't. He got caught butt naked, climbing up the tree, the dogs barking at him. He got grounded for a month.
Yeah, and you owe me still. I never turned you in.
Oh, the famous Green Boys.
Your father was so thrilled you were dating That's one.
Right. Oh, wait, no, I found it. Wait till you see this.
Oh, no. How'd you get this?
Got the film from Dad. I had it transferred.
Look at that outfit. Is that me?
Oh, wait. Here's my favorite part.
Remember how excited we were when we got those goofy outfits for Christmas?
Yeah, I bet you fought over the red hat.
Mitch was always the fastest gun in the neighborhood.
Ladies and gentlemen, the longest and most dramatic death in cinematic history.
Oh, rewind it. I want to see it again.
Steve seems pretty happy.
Yeah, he does. Of course, he's always been pretty good at that, you know?
Good at what?
Masking the truth, you know, camouflaging everything with fun. I mean, he seems a little too happy, don't you think?
No, he seems sincere.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe he's changed.
I don't know. I hope so.
Oh, honey, by the way, Cameron's appeal with the school board is tomorrow morning. Cameron does not deserve to be kicked out of school.
I agree.
Well, maybe you could work up a little enthusiasm.
Sorry, I'm still getting used to the idea I have to deal with this at all. But believe me, I will be there. So, what's the plan?
I will be the logical, supportive parent. And if that doesn't seem to be working, then you could provide a little muscle.
In other words, you talk and I look mean.
Exactly.
Okay.
Hey.
Hey.
What's wrong?
I'm in an accessory crisis.
Oh. I met Clay's dad the other morning.
And that's a problem because...
Clay doesn't know he's here, and his dad asked me not to tell him.
Yeah, I've never got the feeling that Clay was really fond of his dad.
No, he's not. They, haven't seen each other since Clay was 10.
Oh.
Yeah.
A little unsolicited advice. Don't tell him.
It's his dad. I mean, wouldn't you want to know?
No. Leave it alone.
I can't. I can't. Not telling him is the same as lying to him, and...
It's a little bit more complicated than that, man. I mean, you're lucky to have a great dad. Not everybody does. Take it from me. Don't get in the middle of it. Trust me.
Hey.
Hey.
Looks good on you.
Do you ever think about him?
My dad? Sure, every day.
Do you miss him?
No. Mostly I wish he would have left sooner so I wouldn't have to remember him at all.
What if he came back?
Wouldn't change anything. Come on, let's go to lunch.
Wow, I'm impressed. This place is gonna look great when it's restored. I bet Dad can't wait to see it. He always did want one of us to follow in his footsteps.
Why are you really here, Steve?
Okay, I deserve that. Can't expect to show up on your doorstep after 4 years and not be accused of an ulterior motive.
Hey, look, it's not just me, okay? It's the kids, too, you know? I mean, you breeze in here with your jokes and your funny stories. Everyone's really excited to see you. Then you take off, and I'm the guy who's got to come up with the answer when they ask, where's Uncle Steve?
Hey, I love the kids.
I know you love the kids. Are you in some kind of trouble?
I can't seem to shake that irresponsible kid brother thing with you.
Hey, well, maybe that's because I'm the guy who co-signs for a car and then ends up paying the tickets and the fines. I'm the guy who bails you out of jail in Tijuana. I mean, come on, Steve, how many times? How many times?
1,000 times you saved my ass, okay? I thank you. I owe you. I mean, look, can't we just get past this?
Hello.
Right. I'm sorry, honey. Listen, I lost track of the time. I'll meet you both there, okay? Yeah, all right. Bye. I gotta go. It's a school board thing.
Hey. Tell Cam good luck.
Our son does not deserve to be kicked out of Truman High. Like, underneath the attitude, there is a good kid, but you are sentencing him to the same severe punishment you would a student who brought drugs to school or who assaulted a teacher or who concealed a weapon in his locker.
It just doesn't seem fair to us.
Mr. and Mrs. Green, this school, for better or worse, has a 3-strikes policy. That means after the 3rd strike, 0 tolerance, regardless of the offense. And even so, the decision to expel Cameron was not taken lightly. This is his history. Cameron spends at least 6 days a month in detention. He's been involved in 3 incidents of vandalism, including flooding the bathroom, which caused considerable damage.
Not even, that was like 2 years ago.
The list goes on. Truancy, reckless behavior, disrespecting authority, not to mention crashing a truck through school property. You're certainly welcome to review this.
No, jeez.
That won't be necessary.
Well, the board has presented its case. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
I just don't think we should overlook the fact
that... We won't waste any more of your time. We'll live by whatever decision you choose to make. I don't want to argue about this, okay?
You don't want to argue about this? Look, we agreed to fight the expulsion, not to surrender. I was counting on you, Mitch.
Hey, you know what? He deserved this, okay?
Do you honestly believe that?
Cameron thinks this whole thing is a joke, and you know what? We're partially responsible for that. Somehow he grew up thinking his actions have no consequence.
Oh, so what? The solution is, Mitch, he doesn't get any education? Where does that leave
him? We can't come to his rescue every time he gets into trouble. If we do, he'll learn nothing. Cam, I know you don't believe this, but I'm trying to help you.
Thank you.
You don't want Clay to know you're here, but keep showing up.
It's a fatal flaw. One of many, but I'm sure he's told you that.
Megan Green.
I'm Harris. Does Clay know?
I haven't told him. Yet.
Look, it was a mistake talking to you. It's just that, I've never seen him happier. He seems to really care about you. So I wanted to meet you.
Do you watch him all the time?
Some. I was at his first track meet. Fourth grade clarinet recital. His confirmation.
Yeah. He plays the clarinet.
Don't tell him I told you.
Oh, you're asking me to keep a lot of secrets.
There's not a day I don't think about being a part of his life. But believe me, this is for the best. I hurt him too much, and I can't make it up to him.
Why don't you come to his track meet on Friday?
I can't make any promises.
Well, whether or not you come, I'm gonna tell him you're here.
Over there.
No, come on. All right.
I let you win.
Oh, right. Three times in a row.
Of course. It's in the uncle-nephew handbook. Always let the kid win.
They're one of those handbooks for father and sons.
He riding you pretty hard?
Yeah, he is. The school board meeting today didn't even defend me.
I know. He can be a hard ass sometimes, but he's always tough on the ones he loves. Guess you and I just bring that out in him.
Yeah, but it's like he's getting off on watching me suffer.
No, dude, you're shifting the blame.
No, I'm not.
I should know. I'm the king of it.
So that's where I get it from.
Come on, go easy on me. I smoked Cameron three in a row, and I'm whipped.
Oh. No excuses.
I surrender. You getting old, little brother? You know what? I am. Cameron's a good kid, Mitch. Reminds me a lot of me when I was his age.
Now he's a much better basketball player than you ever were.
Maybe you should go a little easy on him.
Hey, maybe you should just stay out of it.
What, I can't have an opinion?
Not about family. That's one thing you know very little about, Steve.
Well, I'm trying to fix that. I'm trying to make up for the past.
Hey, how you plan on making up for the fact you never visited Mom in the hospital the last few months before she died?
You don't think I wanted to be there for her?
I wanted to be there. I was there. You just talk about it.
Okay, you're right. I didn't know how to deal with it.
You deal by dealing with it, not avoiding it. I was there every day. Every day she asked me about you, I had to come up with some excuse. Oh, yeah, Steve's coming. You know, he's got a tough workload. He travels a lot. Pretty soon she got smart. She stopped asking me about you. But you know, one of the last things she ever said to me was? She said, take care of him, Mitch.
Why do you need to tell me that? I mean, don't you think I feel guilty enough?
It was the single biggest challenge of your life, and you walked away from it. You let Mom down, you let me down.
Well, I'm not as strong as you, Mitch. There's no way I could have done what you did, not fall apart.
Yeah, you could have tried.
Times were different then. I was in a bad place. I mean, you didn't understand the pressures that I was under.
You give me the feel sorry for me routine? Face it, Steve, when things get tough, you run. That is what you do.
Well, if I can do it all over again, I'd do the right thing, but I can't. Believe me, I live with that every day. I know it doesn't make it right. I messed up with our mom. But I still have a chance to make it up with you. That's why I came here. I'm sorry, Mitch. I'm sorry. Sorry.
That obvious?
Oh. I think we can all use a few more hugs around here lately.
School board called, and Cameron has now been officially expelled. I can't help but think that somehow along the line I've let her down.
Oh, every parent always feels they could have done more.
Yeah. Well, you know, bigger problem? Mitch and Cameron are growing farther and farther apart, and I don't have any idea how to fix that.
Maybe it's up to Mitch and Cameron to fix that themselves.
My sister-in-law at work. She was my first crush, you know. My brother stole her from me.
Hang on. Do you see me talking on the phone here?
Yes, Mom, and now it's captured on film.
Hang on. I have 72 guests confirmed.
What have you guys done?
Kenny and I are updating the Green Family Archive.
Oh, really? Yeah, let me show you my good set.
Hello? Yeah, it's for you. It's a girl. Wait, I can capture this on film.
I don't think so.
You're destroying my creative vision.
Out.
Oh, come on.
Out.
Great.
Hello? Tamara?
The what? Okay. What did you tell them?
No, that's fine. That's gonna be fine. Just thanks for letting me know.
What's wrong?
There's a warrant out for my arrest.
How much money did you lose?
Over 300,000.
Steve, how does something like that happen?
You take your client's cash, you move it around, make a little money on the side, and put it back before they notice. There isn't an investment broker out there who hasn't tried it.
You were taking other people's money? That's fraud. What the hell were you thinking?
If it wasn't for that one guy who wanted to cash out,
Why didn't you tell me this when you got here?
I mean, you've been busting my chops ever since I rang your doorbell. Can you imagine if I told you this? Besides, I didn't know how serious it was.
Oh, yes, you did, Steve. That's why you're here. You want me to solve the problem. Well, this is too big. I can't help you.
You can't or you won't?
What do you want me to do?
I don't know. Something.
Steve, be smart about this.
It's not that easy. I don't know if I can turn myself in. I don't know that I should. And again, I guess I don't have much of a choice, do I? Well, before I do, is it all right if I stay another day with you and the kids? I understand if you want me to go.
No, of course you can stay.
Clay, can you just stop for a minute? What's...
You kept it a secret. You should have just told me.
Well, Clay, I'm telling you now, all right? Look, he just wants to see how you're doing. He wants to make sure that you're okay.
All right, but he doesn't even have the guts to talk to me?
He doesn't know how. Clay, I mean, he doesn't want to hurt you. I mean, he feels really bad about...
You can't stand there after knowing this guy. For what? A minute? And tell me about how bad he feels? It's too late for that. This guy walked out on me and my mom while we were in the hospital. Why are you on his side?
I'm not on anyone's side.
Yeah, well, maybe that's the problem.
The tar in the streets starts to melt from the heat. And the sweat's running down on my head. I walk 20 miles and I'm dragging my feet.
Hey, I got your stuff out of your gym locker. You know, it's a good thing you're taking them home. They'll get their first washing in months.
Thanks, man.
Hey, you gonna be okay?
Yeah, you know, I'm gonna have to be right.
All right, I'll see you at home.
All right, see you at home.
Hey. You want some help?
Distract Bybee so I can make my escape.
Not that good.
Well, I'm like a ghost. Some people can't see. Others just a drive-by instead. A shadow that drifts on the side of the road. And it's like I'm not. I wander this world. Wander this world. Said I wander this world. Wander this world all alone.
Mom.
Yeah?
I know I never told you, but I'm really proud of the way that you stood up for me at the school board. I'm sorry I'm such a headache.
You're not.
I'm a headache.
More like a migraine sometimes.
I know, and you've been really cool about all this stuff. And I just want you to know, you know, that I know that. And I really appreciate it.
Kim. This is your life. You only have one shot at it. Just promise me that you won't waste it.
I promise.
Good.
What do I do about Dad?
I don't know. Sweetie, I can't rescue you on that one. I think you're just going to have to talk to him.
Okay, kids. Who's your favorite uncle?
Yeah, I'm gonna take the fifth.
Favorite uncle, let me think.
No, that's completely unacceptable. Now, I need a lot more enthusiasm, so show me some love. Megan, who's your favorite uncle?
Uncle Steve.
Uncle Steve.
Uncle Steve!
Uncle Steve!
Get out of here, you're our only uncle.
All right, we need to get you on camera now. Uncle Steve, give it to me.
Okay. All right, let's hear it for the green man. Come on. Let's flex those muscles. I know my boy's ripped up like a bad report card.
All right, Uncle Steve, listen to me. You're going to go on record right now and promise all of us that you will be here next Christmas without fail. Okay, now say it and look into the camera, okay?
All right, I'll be here next Christmas.
You got that as evidence, right?
It's on. Yeah, now you can't take it back.
No, I can't take it back.
Hey!
Donald! Don't want to go to Mexico.
What?
This was your plan all along, wasn't it? Wasn't it? This was your job out of the country. You want to run, Steve? Go ahead, run. I don't want anything to do with it. You need money. I feel so stupid. You know, you manipulated me from the minute you walked in the door. And all that talk about Mom. Wanted to spend time with my family. You didn't mean any of that.
That's not true.
Yeah, well, it's true, Steve. You know, really tell me, because I don't know anymore.
I'm all alone. I don't have anywhere else to go. And my brother, Mitch, you're all I've got. Steve. Look, I walk into a police station tomorrow. I'm looking at 5 to 7 years of my life. I messed up, all right? If there's ever a time I needed you, it's now. I'm scared. Please help me.
Help you what?
Run.
about a timeout? This court's gotten a lot of use lately.
Cheaper than therapy.
You know, there's this incredible thing I do. While you talk, I drink my coffee and listen. Wanna try it out?
Steve wants me to help him run.
You're kidding. Are you considering it?
I don't know. He'd go to prison for a long time, Mary. He needs my help.
He certainly doesn't deserve it. So what, now you're aiding and abetting a fugitive?
He's my brother. He's my family.
He embezzled money from people.
He made a mistake. You know, he is scared. I can't just not do anything.
He's counting on that, Mitch. I don't see how you can keep bailing your brother out and still come down so hard on your son.
Wait, that is unfair. I come down hard on Cameron because he is young, he's got his whole life ahead of him, he can change. It's too late for Steve. I guess I never wanted to admit that.
He's a grown man. He's not your responsibility.
You know the sad thing? Sad thing, he's always been my responsibility. I promised Mom I'd take care of him.
I had really good intentions. I guess I just wanted you to have the chance to have a dad. I mean, I do, and I'm lucky. I know that now more than ever.
I'm sorry I took it all out on you.
It's just, I was so angry.
Thinking about all the times I watched those other kids' fathers meet them at the finish line.
Take pictures with them, celebrate.
Now you tell me he was there all alone. Hiding.
We've been through a lot, Clay. A lot. And I would never do anything to hurt you or jeopardize what we have. I'm sorry.
Take that upstairs.
Hey, Dad.
What?
I'm sorry.
Okay.
Okay. You know, I'm not like Uncle Steve. I'm not gonna turn out like him.
I know, I'm not gonna let you. But things have got to change.
I want to go back to school.
We can work on that. But I'm going to be tough on you. But just because I'm tough on you, Cam, doesn't mean I don't love you.
As long as you don't give up on me.
Not even. I'm going to get that. Hello. Speaking.
Yeah, detective. He is my brother. No, I don't mind answering a few questions. Sure. No problem. Okay. Okay.
You tell him I was here?
They didn't ask. But they're coming over here. They want to talk to me. Steve, you gotta turn yourself in.
Coming alive. Both runners are making their move from the outside.
Are you sure you don't want me to stay?
No, it's a brother thing. No, I'm the famous Green Boys.
All right, just tell them goodbye for me.
I will.
Bye.
On the second turn, it's Central ahead with Madison close behind.
I'll get you the best lawyer in town.
What are you gonna tell Dad?
What do you want me to tell?
Tell him that I had some trouble. No. Tell him I met this girl and we went out.
I'm left to go.
I mean, I can't believe you're turning me in. I thought I could count on
you. Hey, I am not turning you in. I would never turn you in, Steve. You're my brother, for God's sake. You came to my house. The police called me. What do you want me to do? You want me to lie to them?
Yes, that's what brothers are supposed to do. You watch each other's back. If the situation were reversed, I'd lie for you.
Yeah, well, that's the difference between you and me, Steve. I would never ask you to.
Go to hell.
Look, I'm gonna be there. Okay, I'm gonna go through this with you.
See, you're really not, though, because you're gonna be here with your family and your fireplace and your cozy little domestic problems, and I'm gonna be in prison. Mitch, I'm sorry, wait. It's not your fault. I'm just scared. Tore in my life.
I'm sorry things didn't work out differently.
Yeah. You and me both.
You know, I still love you.
Megan back from the track meet yet?
No, she's not. I'll let her know you came by.
Okay.
Hey, you can relax. Steve, it was a false alarm.
That's completely unacceptable. Now, I need a lot more enthusiasm, so show me some love. Megan, who's your favorite uncle?
Uncle Steve.
Uncle Steve!
Uncle Steve!
Get out of here, you're our only uncle.
All right, we need to get you a camera, Uncle Steve. Give it to me.
All right, let's hear it for the green man.
Come on.
Let's flex those muscles. I know my voice ripped up like a bad report.
All right, Uncle Steve, Uncle Steve. Okay, right now, you're going to go on record right now and promise all of us that you will be here next Christmas without fail. Okay, now say it and look into the camera, okay?
All right, I'll be here next Christmas.
You got that as evidence, right?
It's on camera.
Yeah, no, you can't take it back.
Nope, I can't take it back.
You think they'll find him?
Is it terrible if I say I hope not?
Not at all.
Ha ha ha.